Hi Hunters! The topic of this video is open directories. We also get to know how to download and detect some malware samples. Let's get started! If open directories are configured incorrectly or specially customized, showing directory listing that skipped on the server, then that could potentially yield sensitive information to an attacker. And in some cases, it could even become a place to keep payload files or collected stolen information from the infected machines. Opendirs are basically unprotected directories of documents, pictures, videos, databases, software, and a lot of different sensitive information that can be used with malicious intent. Generally, open directories contain a wealth of fresh samples and different tags. You can find tasks contained open directories by tag Opendir in ANY.RUN's public submissions. So let's turn our words into deeds and open my task from the history by clicking on the Recent History link at the navigation bar. As you can see, the task's verdict is no threats detected. There can be a lot of reasons. For example, it could be a lack of time. Let's restart the task, adding some time to its duration. Task has started, and the VM needs some time for detecting threats. If you look at the process tree, you can see the main process creates its child process and start network activity. After a while, the system detected good loader. If you open CMD process detail and click on More Info button, you can see its command line and other additional details of the process. Based on such activity as deleting the initial executable file through injected system file, I would guess that it's Formbook Trojan. It takes around 1 minute for the infection process to make its routines and inject into Explorer process. Wait a second. That's right. It is. Additionally, Formbook injected several processes such as Netsch and Firefox. Now we're checking its behavior activities and can see the Formbook is detected by several signatures, both local and network. We're going to advance details of Netsch process. From here, we could check the details and local signature too, and also can go to the its child process if you want. But now, let's back and take a look at the HTTP request section. There is a URL with Opendir tag. Let's know what's kept inside this open directory. We need to click on the icon of the left side of the URL address to copy it. Let's use ANY.RUN's feature Remote Clipboard and paste URL into VM, avoiding manual input. We're deleting the name of the downloadable file at the end of the URL and click Send. After, we need to open a web browser that you prefer and paste the URL into the address bar. For example, let's choose Firefox. Just close the process details window and roll up Firefox to make process tree more visual. Now we're pasting the URL into the address bar and pressing Enter. Well, sometimes waiting for a response from the server takes time. In our case, it took around 40 seconds. I fast forward the video to the moment getting the results. Here it is. After the directory has loaded, we can see what this directory keeps. There are hive files, scripts, Microsoft Office files, executable files, and nested directories. There is a file from our task too. Let's download any file and explore what it is. I decided to download file document 001 because I think this file is a malicious document, and I want to know what is the payload was delivered to the infected machine. Just go around all the security measures, open the maldoc and click on the Enable Adding button. So, something is going to start. Let's see what exactly happens. Apparently, this maldoc has macros, which through the exploitation of CVE-2070-11882 downloads and runs the executable file, which turns out to be Lockybot Trojan. The Trojan was also detected both by network and local signature. Furthermore, we can't be sure that exactly is Lockybot in the front of us when we look inside packets sent by it. And if there is a CKA.RUN inside the packets, don't doubt, this sample belongs to the Trojan. In spite of the fact that it can be complicated and confusing, you can download all of those files during one analysis anyway and determine what threads are in this open directory. But we won't do this today. I want to remind you that you can create new tasks, subscribing links to the executable files in open directories, and after you can search the similar tasks in the public submissions. That's all for today. Hope this video was useful for you. Don't forget to give your feedback in the comments. It was Olga. Bye!